Hold on one second. We're right ahead.
So I have my presentation on why everyone wants to add MKMGs. So before we go ahead and what is skydiving? Everyone kind of knows it's kind of something mandatory, but it's designed to throw the definition up there. Definition is the sport of jumping from an aircraft while performing acrobatic maneuvers as a result for opening and landing bucket. So some basic information about the sport. I've jumped from 13,500 feet. And when you're pulling the cord, you have to 30,500 feet and 50,000 feet. Most experienced jumpers pull it around 30,000 feet, but when you're ready to jump and you're getting certified, jump around 50,500 feet, you want some distance from the ground on the camp to get used to it. We jump out of mainly planes, helicopters, and fighter planes, mostly in place. So, and then the sport encompasses 350,000 people worldwide. We're kind of a small sport, we're trying to do it. And there's many different disciplines within the sport. There's five major ones, and I'll explain them later, but the five major ones are RW, which is relative work, which is formation skydiving, wing sitting, which is explosives. Free flying, which is what these guys in the picture over here doing. They head down fly and they sit and fly and they fly on their backs. Formation, canopy flying, which is called crew, canopy relative work, and accuracy. And I threw tandem jumping on there because today I'm going to try to get you guys to go on a tandem jump at some point in your lives. So, tandem jumping is essentially someone who's a beginner who's never jumped before, goes to a drop zone, takes a moment, obviously, gets attached to a very experienced jumper, and jumps on the plane with him. So, basic anatomy of a parachute. Okay. So, down here, we have the front of the container. And on the bottom half is under the step flap right here, is where your main canopy goes, and up here is where your reserve goes. Right here is your full hacky, or your full PVC pipe thing. It's connected to a pilot chute, which is connected to a thing that holds your bag in. When you're under when you're free falling, you'll pull that, throw your pilot chute. The pilot chute will come out, up over the air, catch the air, open the pit, open the top slab, bring out your deployment bag, and hopefully open the canopy like that. Under your canopy, you'll have your lines. Your CMD lines are your two outside lines which help you steer. They connect to you in your risers, which connect to your steering pedals. These two important things I want to show you. This is your cutaway handle, and this is your reserve handle. So, in case it was an off pocket when you were jumping, you have your cutaway handle, and you peel it and you pull it. But that would cut you away from your main canopy, and you pull this. And then it would open up your reserve. And then, lastly, one more thing. This little device right here. It's called an MKMG. It's an automatic activation device. It's kind of new to sport. They've had it in there for about 15 years or so. And it's recommended around the world. My drop zone requires it. But it's pretty much, it's going to be inside your container. And it senses where you are, how high you are off the ground, and how fast you're falling. And if you're under a certain height, falling at a certain speed, it automatically deploys your reserve for you. In case you are acting faster than you are. And here's some different types of different disciplines. So this is another sport. This is like a big wave formation. I think it's like 40 people. Doing a Ferris wheel. I mean, this is a little four-way. Maybe that's a free fly. This is the head-down world record. It's 180 people flying head-down. And then this is someone who's doing a sit fly. This is wing sitting. This is like two people who's wing sitting. Wing sitting, when you fly, it adds about 40 seconds to your free fall. This is that more fabric. I want to get into wing sitting at some point, but think about 200 jumps. You got to get pretty experienced to do it. I started using the wing sitting world record. It was 200 people in a wing sitting flock. This is the one. Canopy that was more. These are the canopy formations. This stuff's really dark. This right here is very impressive. This is a world record. Proved to land right at the middle of that sensor. They're coming out of the PCBs only from the middle of the sensor. Okay. So why should you guys go skydiving? So I put two major reasons why you guys should go skydiving. One, here's some misconception. Well, okay, inherently, yes, skydiving is dangerous. You're jumping out of a plane. It's a dangerous thing, it's not natural. But it's a lot safer than people realize. There's some misconceptions. People don't think there's a lot of safety precautions on the regulations. There are a lot of regulations. And the statistics that I'll show you kind of prove that. And then also, it'll be one of the most amazing things you'll ever do in your life, if not the industry. Let's talk about some of the different safety components. So first, experience. The guys that you'll be jumping with, just to become a tandem master, you have to have 500 jumps and 3 years in the sport. And by master, I mean they know everything. The master package, the master jumpers, they've got 500 minutes of free fall time right now. They're really, really good at what they do. Most of the guys that you'll be jumping with, 10 years in the sport, 20 years in the sport, 10,000 jumps, 5,000 jumps, jumping forever, really know what they're doing, really good at what they're doing. Second, it kind of goes without saying, jump into canopies. The first one for you guys will be a tandem packer at the drop zone, packing the canopy for you. They do it every day, they're really good at what they're doing. They do it nonstop all day, pack up 100 tandems a day, they're really good at what they do. And then go to the reserve. And the reserve can only be packed by an FAA certified rigger, and the time they put into packing the reserve. I'm not becoming a rigger because of this. We've got 3 hours per pack job. Usually it takes 15 to 20 minutes to pack a tandem. It takes 3 hours. They meticulously fold every release. They seal their line perfectly so there's no tangles. And then I mentioned before the automatic activation device. And that's that little device that sets your height and speed. Then lastly, gear checks. That's a picture over there of someone doing a gear check and someone like for a jump. And this happens like throughout the sport. Everyone does it. Have to do it multiple times before you jump. Do it before you get in the plane, do it while you're in the plane. They check your pins, they make sure they're in the right place. They check your handles, make sure they're in correctly. They check all your straps and your harness. So here's some statistics. So 2012, there were 3.5 million jumps. Of those 3.5 million, there were 19 fatal incidents. And then, of those 19 fatal incidents, there was 1 tandem-related fatality. So, Most of the fatalities that really do occur in skydiving are from like fun jumpers, professional jumpers who do it a lot. Because when you jump a lot, yeah, you risk getting hurt, build up obviously. But you guys, when you're jumping one time, it says 1 in 100,000, and that's been like the growing statistic because other than the past 3 or 4 years, it's been about 19 or 20 for every 2 million jumps. So they say about 1 in 100,000, but the past 3 or 4 years have been the jumps have been increasing, and the number of fatalities really haven't gone up at all. And just to put it into perspective, driving, 1 in 6,000, and then motorcycling, 1 in 1,000. And fun fact, more people die from falling coconuts and truck tracks and falling out of the car every year. So what does it feel like? You know, I'm going to try and explain what it feels like, but I'll send a video to you guys after. You know, it's amazing, but there's no real vertigo. There's no like stomach dropping type of feeling. Because when you jump out of a plane, you hit by the rope when you jump the plane, you're not jumping in dead air. So you hit that relative wind, and then you're hitting terminal velocity within 10 seconds. So you never really get that stomach dropping feeling, because I feel like a lot of people are scared to get that feeling. They don't like that feeling. You never get that. It's just a rush on your face, and it's amazing. It's beautiful, and it's awesome. You can see these guys, and I don't know how fun. Sure you guys are doing really, really quick.
Thank you.
stated the different facts for you guys. I've kind of tried to show you what it feels like. Skydiving is awesome. It's beautiful. I do it every weekend, so I try to do it every weekend now. And I definitely think, I hope I convince some of you to try to go at least once in a while.
It definitely sounds like a lot of fun. How expensive is it?
That's another thing. It's about $250, but with the student discount, I mean, okay, first off, it's one time a year, okay? You never get it. So $250 is always one time a year, like, for probably the most amazing stage of life. But I have a coupon of $100 off.
How long does it take to change your passion?
So, free fall is about a minute, and the first time you do it, you only remember it. It's so awesome, you can see it, you see the whole thing, and then it's about 5 minutes on the canopy until you're down back on the ground.
Really cool.
In the summertime, you know, it's a little bit tight.
Do you only jump when it's nice weather?
No. Well, you can only jump when there's no clouds and it's not windy and not raining. But you jump when it's really cold outside, there's snow all over the ground. But it's like minus 30 or something.
How many jumps do you have?
Right now I have 60, and I'm going to try to get to 200 really in the summer because I want to start wind season and have a camera and everything.
Do you have some way to lower that cost? I mean, for yourself?
For myself, well, after you get certified, it costs $25 a jump. I spent my life savings pretty much to become certified, so. So now it's cheap.
How many jumps do you have to have before you can go by yourself?
You need 25 jumps to get certified, and you do a whole class. It's called the AFF class. You've got your own canopy the entire time, but you start off jumping next to two instructors. And then eventually you graduate to jump with one instructor, and then you jump with a coach, who's one going down to an instructor, and then you do some solo jumps, and eventually you get certified.
Have you just jumped in your own like zone, or have you gone to other places?
I've done it in Arizona, in North Carolina, and in Connecticut. I want to do it, I'm going to Istanbul next year, I want to go jump up there. I kind of want to make it like a habit wherever I go.
How are you scared for this?
Obviously. For me, it was more scary because for me, every jump was a test, and I had to pass doing certain maneuvers in the air. So I was really nerve-wracking, but yeah, the first time I jumped, you're gonna be nervous. That's how it is. You jump in a plane the first time, you're going up in a plane, the door's open, and you're seeing people jump out of the plane, and all of a sudden you're out of the plane.
So where are you in college? Obviously you don't do this for the rest of your life.
because I don't want to make a job out of it. Because I think if you make a job out of something like this, it won't be as fun anymore. I know a lot of guys who are tennis jumpers, and they still enjoy skydiving, but they do this every weekend. They just attack people. Just get the value. It'll get, but you get the right.
Thank you.